Hello everyone, welcome to this new series that is JEE Revision Target 2019. This is a very important series because we are hardly 2.5 months, not even 2.5, only 2 months left for JEE Main exam coming up. So this series will go on till almost end. How much ever I can, I'll extend it, and I'll be picking up questions from different sources, that is either previous year questions or from different books, that is H.C. Verma, anything. I can pick from any source or resource I want. And the other thing I wanted to mention is this videos will be out every day, either one video or two videos, unless I don't have any work, that is my test or probably a lot of record writing will be there. If that is not there, unless those things preoccupy me, this videos will be out every day with different type of questions from maths, physics and chemistry. All three subjects I'll be picking questions and solving them for you. A wide range of questions involving formula, concept and tricks sometimes if I have, I'll be picking up such kind of questions, and hence I request you all to watch the videos completely. I'll be keeping the duration very short because I don't want to waste you people's time too much. You people, your time is very important and you have to use it very efficiently, and that can be done by watching videos, I agree. Even I used to do that, but you have to minimize it as much as possible and increase your problem solving efficiency by solving it. But use these videos as an aid to your own ability. Learn new tricks, write them down, keep a formula book at least now, so that from now on if you have not yet kept it. And with that note, let's begin. And before that, I wanted to say that if you have just stumbled upon this video, do subscribe, because you are going to get a lot of input for JEE 2019 from my channel from now on. And please give a like to this video and share it with your friends also, so that even they learn from it. And with that note, let's begin with this video. Thank you. Hello everyone, welcome to this new episode and to the first video of JEE revision series. In this series, I'll be picking up, as I've told you before, I'll be picking up questions from anywhere which I feel like, and the questions are good, either from previous year questions or from different books or H.C. Verma or any questions. I'll be discussing those questions, either O.P. Tandon for chemistry or anything, whatever resources I have, I'll be collecting questions from that and I'll be discussing. It'll be either maximum, as I've told, two questions in one video, or probably even one question in one video. If it is one question per video, then I'll be trying my level best to explain it within 2 minutes, because you people are supposed to do it in 2 minutes, and so am I. Well, I won't be skipping steps so that you people understand very well, but yet I'll be trying to accomplish that task. With that note, let's begin. This question says, by the way, I have picked up 2 questions for this video and I'll be solving them. Both the questions are from JEE Main 2014 question paper and we shall be solving them. Please make a note, because a formula is about to be used in the next question, and I hope you have a pen and a paper with you so that you solve along with me. First, I would encourage you to pause the video and try this question by yourself, and then watch the video for the solution. If you don't get it, even if you get it, it's fine. Probably your method and mine may be different. Let's see that. So this question says, the current voltage relation of a diode is given by this equation. I is equal to e power 1000 V by T minus 1, which is the answer will come in milliamperes, where the applied voltage is V and the temperature is T, which is measured in Kelvin. If a student makes an error measuring the voltage is 0.01, the error is 0.01 volts plus or minus 0.01 volts while measuring the current of 5 milliamps at 300 Kelvin, then what will be the error in value of current? They want delta I. Delta V is given, and temperature T is given. I is also given. These are the things which are given to us. Now, how do we find delta I? First, see this equation, that is I is equal to e power 1000 V by T minus 1. First of all, just have a look at it. This is in milliamps, and the current given here is in milliamps, that is 5 milliamps. Now what you do is, we'll substitute 5 over here, because it is current. 5 is equal to e power 1000 V by T minus 1, and e power 1000 V by T is equal to 6 is what we get. This will just be a number, because milliamps and milliamps gets cancelled. Now we got this, we'll keep this aside because we'll need it later. Now I'll take the same equation, I is equal to e power 1000 V by T minus 1. What do I want? I want delta I, right? So let me differentiate. Delta I is equal to e power, I'll be getting constants outside, 1000 by T e power 1000 V by T into delta V. Right? This is what I'll be getting. I need this value. Clearly I have temperature value, delta V value, and I have this value, right? Can't I find the delta I easily? Yes, I can. 1000 divided by temperature is 300 times this value is this one, that is 6 times delta V. Delta V is 0.01, that is 1 by 100. Just cancel out things, two zeros and one from here, these three go away, and I have 6 by 30, 3 and 10, so I have 1 by 5, which is 0.2, and it should be in milliamps, because we are measuring delta I, and hence our option will be A. I hope you understood how to do this question. Let's see the next one now. The next question says, a thin convex lens made from crown glass of refractive index 3 by 2 has focal length f. When it is measured in two different liquids having refractive index indices 4 by 3 and 5 by 3, it has focal lengths f1 and f2. You obviously know when they put it in a medium, the focal length changes, and respectively, the correct relation between the focal lengths is. We want the relation between f1, f and f2. How do we do it? So for this, as I told, there is one important formula which has to be used. Please write it down somewhere, probably in your formula book or wherever you are writing now. Please make a note of it. That is, fm by f is equal to mu minus 1 whole divided by mu by mu m minus 1. Easy to remember? Yes, it is. fm denotes focal length in medium. Mu m denotes focal length of the medium in which the lens is placed. Now, let's take the first case where 4 by 3 is the medium's that is the whatever the liquid we are using, its refractive index. 4 by 3 is actually water, you already know that. Now, fm in this case will be f1, let's take that case, divided by f is equal to mu minus 1, mu is 3 by 2 always, 3 by 2 minus 1, divided by mu is 3 by 2 again, divided by mu m in this case will be 5 by 3 because we are taking the first case, that is 5 by 3 minus 1. From this, let's find out the relation. Now I have f1 by f, let me simplify this, 1.5 minus 1 is 0.5 divided by 3 by 2 into 3 by 5 minus 1. I have 1 by 2 whole divided by 9 by 10 minus 1. 9 by 10 minus 1. Right? In this case I get f1 by f is equal to 1 by 2 into 9 10 by minus 1, that is minus 5. f1 is equal to minus 5 times f is what I get in this case. Right? And the next case says f2 divided by f is equal to 3 by 2 minus 1 divided by 3 by 2 divided by, I'm sorry, I had to take 4 by 3 here. 4 by 3, this was to be 4, 9 by 8, and this should have been 9 minus 1, 8. 8 divided by 2 should have been 4. So I would have got f1 is equal to 4f. I was thinking something is wrong. So f1 is 4f, and the second case here I get 5 by 3 minus 1. So I get 1 by 2 whole divided by this case, right? 3 by 2 into 3 by 5 minus 1. That is 1 by 2 into minus 10, I think. 10 minus 9 minus 10, yeah, minus 10 by 1 is what I get. That is minus 5. F2 is equal to minus 5f. And f1 is 4f. Now we got these two relations. We'll check carefully. This is not at all the case because f1 is not equal to f2. We are clearly seeing that. And f1 by f is 4, right? f1 by f is 4. That means f1 is greater than f. f1 is greater than f. This has to be the case. And f2 is less than 0 because we are getting a negative sign. Since from this case we don't have f is less than 0. So f2 has to be less than 0 because f is positive, right? So f1 is greater than f from this case and f2 is negative from this case. And hence option B will be our right answer. So thanks a lot for watching this video. Thank you.